got it now isolated into two main areas, really at the back part of the ship, as well as at the front.
Navy officials say fires are still burning on USS Bonhomme Richard, but early reports show no major engineering damage, and despite taking on water, the ship is remaining stable. There is about 1 million gallons of fuel on board, but crews have been able to isolate the tanks from the fire.
Below the water line and far, far away from any heat source. The risk is very low.
More than 1,200 water drops have been made by helicopters, and officials say the priority is still just getting the fire out. No word on a cause yet, and it's unclear exactly how much damage has been done or if the ship is even salvageable. After burning for more than 2 days, the Navy says the fire could be out by tomorrow.
We're very hopeful that our efforts are making progress.
Since the fire started on Sunday morning, thick smoke has been pouring from the ship and into nearby communities.
Communities that are being impacted by this fire are low-income communities of color. We call them environmental justice communities. These are the communities that have more pollution. They're in the top 10% of the most polluted communities in the state of California.
Diane Takvorian is executive director of the Environmental Health Coalition and sits on the California Air Resources Board.
It's hard to breathe when you're in regular smoke. If that smoke includes synthetic material like plastics and metal and potentially fuels, then it's even worse.
Takvorian wishes county officials would treat this as an emergency disaster and work to get people out of smoky areas around the ship.
There needs to be triage that's happening immediately. Shelters should be made available to people that are COVID safe, but this is an immediate need. We can't wait days, weeks, months.
The levels that you guys are seeing right now, are they at like an okay level in terms of like you guys don't need to put out like a warning or anything? They're, even though there is smoke in the air, you guys are telling people to avoid the area, there's no like huge threat to public safety or anything? Or...
Right now we're not seeing a big threat, but our advice to people is still the same, and that is that if you're smelling if you're nearby and you're smelling a strong smell of smoke, is really to stay indoors.
The County Air Pollution Control District has brought in mobile monitors to check the air around the ship and haven't found any volatile organic compounds, but they don't know everything that's in the air. Officials are expecting to get detailed testing results tomorrow.
This would look at a variety of chemical compounds in the air so we can get a better idea of what came out of that fire.
People have reported smelling smoke all the way in Oceanside, and closer to the ship, people have complained of headaches and trouble breathing. Matt Hoffman, KPBS News.